Welcome to the chemistry class. Today we are going to discuss about the one more colligative property, that is depression of freezing point. Depression means decrease, okay. So in last class we discussed about the boiling point, elevation of the boiling point. There the boiling point will going to be increased, while here freezing point will going to be decreased. That is the depression of the freezing point, and here it also depends upon the number of the solute particle irrespective of its nature. That's why the depression of freezing point is also one of the colligative property. Okay, let us go further. We are talking about depression of the freezing point, means what is the meaning of the freezing point? Freezing point is the temperature at which vapor pressure of substance in liquid phase becomes equals to vapor pressure of substance in solid phase. Okay, the vapor pressure and temperature are directly proportional to each other. If the temperature increases, vapor pressure also increases. If the temperature decreases, vapor pressure decreases. So here freezing point means freezing, that is the liquid state freezes to solid, liquid converts to solid, that is nothing but freezing. So the exact definition of the freezing point, freezing is the process of converting liquid into solid, that water freezes into ice. Okay, so if we are going for the freezing point, it is the temperature at which the vapor pressure of the substance in the liquid phase becomes equals to the vapor pressure of the substance in the solid phase. It means the solid as well as liquid phases are in dynamic equilibrium, in dynamic equilibrium. So whenever pure solvent is there, it will going to, that pure solvent will going to freeze into the solid solvent, okay. And then when we add the non-volatile solute, when we add the non-volatile solute, during that time what happens, the freezing point will be decreases, the freezing point will going to be decrease, that is the depression of the freezing point of the solution decreases as compared with the pure solvent. So let me explain you terms here. TF naught, that is the temperature of freezing of the pure solvent, or freezing temperature, temperature of freezing of pure solvent, okay, and TF is the temperature of freezing of solution, temperature of freezing of solution. Okay, so as I am telling you, the temperature of the freezing of the solution decreases, it decreases, that is the depression of the freezing point. Why? Because we are added the non-volatile solute, and TF naught is the temperature of freezing of the pure solvent. So always keep in mind that TF is lesser than the TF naught, that is the freezing temperature or temperature of the freezing of the solution is lesser than the that of the temperature of freezing of the solvent. So the depression of the freezing point, that is delta TF, can be given as TF naught minus TF, because TF naught is the highest value. Okay, so the depression in freezing point, that is delta TF, is equals to TF naught minus TF. Clear? So for generally, if we talk about the delta TF, is directly proportional to the molality, that is for a dilute solution the depression in freezing point is directly proportional to molality, is directly proportional to molality. I am going to replace this directly proportionality sign by adding one more constant, that is delta TF is equals to Kf into molality m. Kf into molality m. Here Kf is called as cryoscopic constant or molal depression constant or freezing point depression constant. So here generally for dilute solution the depression in freezing point is directly proportional to molality, and this directly proportionality sign is removed by adding the one more constant, that is delta Tf is equals to Kf into m, where Kf is the cryoscopic constant or molal depression constant or freezing point depression constant. So let us go for here. So what is our derivation? Delta Tf is equals to Kf into m. Delta Tf is equals to Kf into m. And then if Kf delta Tf becomes equals to Kf when m is equals to 1, it means we can define the cryoscopic constant as it is the depression in freezing point, it is the depression in freezing point when molality is 1. It means 1 mole of the solute is dissolved in 1000 grams of the solvent. That is molality is what we can say 1. Molality must be 1. During that time the cryoscopic constant becomes equals to the depression of the depression in freezing point. And the unit of the Kf is similar, that is delta Tf, Kf is equals to delta Tf divided by m. So unit will be kkz per mole. Kkz per mole. Temperature is measured in terms of Kelvin, and molality means number of moles of the solute dissolved in the mass of the solvent is taken in kz, that is kz per mole is the unit. So this is the unit of the Kf and definition of the Kf. Clear? So now let us go for the main derivation. So now we have delta Tf is equals to Kf into m, Kf into m. Now we know that what is m? M is the molality. So that I will convert. Kf keep as it is. Molality is a number of moles of the solute. Always for solute we are going to take the 2 term, that is 2 number, and then n2 divided by molality, the number of the moles of the solute divided by what is the mass of the solvent, that is mass of the solvent W1 taken in terms of kg, that is divided by 1000. Already I explained you the similar terms while solving the boiling point derivation. So here again I will make this one as Kf as it is. N2 means what is N2 will be W2 by M2. So it will be like this 1000 to W1. Are you getting why I am writing like this? Because N2 is nothing but number of moles of the solute, that is mass divided by molar mass, W2 divided by M2, and it will go upside into 1000 divided by W1. Therefore, delta Tf is equals to Kf into W2 into 1000 divided by M2 into W1. So, in your problematic section, they are going to ask you the molar mass. So, take the molar mass term separate out, that is Kf into W2 into 1000 divided by delta Tf into W1. So this is our expression. Clear? See here, m2 is equals to kf into w2 into 1000 divided by delta tf into w1. Okay, so this is the derivation. Now let us go for the graphical representation. So in case of graphical representation, we are going to draw vapor pressure and temperature, vapor pressure versus temperature. Okay, let us consider this curve. This is for the pure liquid solvent. Okay, so at a certain temperature, what happens? At certain point, the pure liquid solvent turns to frozen solvent. Now it is a frozen solvent. So this is the point. So this is the point where the liquid is converting into solid. So I will take here, this I am going to take as TF naught, temperature of freezing of the pure solvent. Now let us go for the, let us imagine this is the curve for the solution. When is, as it is decreasing, we are talking about the depression, we are talking about the depression means decreasing. So what happens, this curve touches to the frozen solvent, this curve will going to touch the frozen solvent, and this is the point where we are going to take the temperature of freezing, that is TF, and the difference between these two, it will be delta TF, and we know that delta TF is equals to TF naught minus TF. So this is how graphical representation of the depression in freezing point can be explained. So once again I will tell you, similar to boiling point, only the thing is here there is a decrease, here there is a decrease. See here, freezing point is the temperature at which vapor pressure of the substance in the liquid phase becomes equal to the vapor pressure of the substance in the solid phase. Okay, and the during freezing, what happens? There is a dynamic equilibrium occurs between the liquid phase and solid phase. And then we are going to explain the terms TF naught, temperature of freezing of the pure solvent, and TF is the temperature of freezing of the solution. And then whenever the non-volatile solute is added to solvent, during that time the freezing will be lesser. That's why TF is lesser than TF naught, and the depression in freezing point delta TF is equals to TF naught minus TF. And then generally for the dilute solution, the delta TF is directly proportional to the molality, and this directly proportionality is removed by one more constant, KF. KF is called as cryoscopic constant or molar depression constant, or we can say that freezing point depression constant. And then if I am going to define the KF means, what happens, KF becomes equals to TF when, sorry, that is delta TF when the molality is 1. So molality is 1 means that is 1 mole of the solute should be added in, the mass of the solvent should be taken in terms of the kg. So what we can say that KF, that is cryoscopic constant, is equals to, or it is the depression in freezing point when the molality is 1. And then KF unit will be similar to KB. KF unit is similar to KB, that is K kg per mole. So this is how we can explain about the term KF. And then again come to our derivation, delta TF is equals to KF into M, that is molality. And then we know that how to express the molality. Molality is the number of moles of the solute, that is N2 divided by mass of the solvent, W1 divided by 1000. And again N2 can be, that number of moles can be written in terms of mass divided by molar mass. And finally you are going to get the expression that delta TF is equals to KF into W2 into 1000 divided by M2 into W1. So that is we for the problematic section many times m2 will be asked. So separate out the term m2 is equals to kf into w2 into 1000 divided by delta tf into w1. If we go for the graphical representation, in case of graph, that is we are going to draw the graph of vapor pressure versus temperature, and here it is the curve for the pure liquid solvent, and at the point it starts to freezing and this is the frozen solvent, and this point is taken as a TF0, and one more curve, that is for the solution, when it touches to the frozen solvent curve, that temperature is taken as, that is the point which is taken as the temperature of the freezing TF, and the difference between these two is called as delta TF, that is the depression in the freezing point. Okay, let us go for the one of the problem based on this that we are going to continue. Thank you. So let us go for the one problem which is based on the freezing point, that is the depression of the freezing point. See here, what is the problem? 1.00 gram of a non-volatile solute dissolved in 50 gram of benzene. So 1.00 gram of the non-volatile solute is dissolved in 50 gram of benzene. See here, this is more, it means it acts as a solvent, okay, and here 1.00 gram is the solute, directly they have given as solute only. Sometimes if you are getting confusion, means just look at the numbers, if it is larger, we are going to tell that solvent is the larger component, so the value which is larger that acts as a solvent and which is lesser that acts as a solute. And then that 50 gram of benzene, they have added 1.00 gram of the solute. Lower the freezing point of benzene by 0.40 Kelvin, okay, and then the freezing point of depression constant of the benzene is 5.12 kkg per mole. Find the molar mass of the solute. They have asked to find the molar mass of the solute. So let us go for the what are the terms they have given? Let me write those terms, then only we can able to understand what is what they have asked. See here. So what are the terms given? 1.00 gram of non-electrolyte solute. It means that is the weight of the solute. Weight of the solute. Weight, that is W. We are taking the solute. Solvent means 1, solute means 2. W2 is 1.00 gram, W2 is 1.00 gram, and then again it is added in 50 gram of the benzene, 50 gram of the benzene, that is also W but 1, why it is solvent, that is 50 gram. Then see here, it lowered the freezing point of the benzene by 0.40 Kelvin. So directly they have given delta TF, there is no need to find out the delta TF, that is TF minus TF naught, no need, TF naught minus TF is no need, directly they have given the, what way they have given, lowered the freezing point, that is the depression, decreasing, lowered the freezing point of the benzene by 0.40, that is delta TF is equals to 0.40 K. And then the freezing point depression constant, what is the freezing point depression constant, is nothing but Kf, freezing point depression constant is nothing but Kf, okay, and then Kf they have given as 5.12, and the unit, many times the unit is also asked, okay. So now they have asked to find out the molar mass, M2, they are asking to find out the M2. So as we have the formula, depression of the freezing point, we need to calculate M2. So directly I will take M2 is equals to Kf into W2 into 1000 divided by delta TF into W1. Are you getting? Simply, you just cross multiply these terms, you are going to get the M2, and then now substitute the value of Kf and all these things. Kf is 5.12 into W2 is 1.00 is nothing but 1 only into 1000 divided by delta T of 0.40 into W1, that is 50. If you calculate all this, if you substitute and if you simplify this, finally you are going to get 256 gram per mole as your value. So, sometimes this is not directly given. Sometimes this is not directly given, but in this problem they have given directly. The freezing point lowered, already they said lowered. Lowered means the depression, depression of the freezing point, delta TF is directly given. So, you have to take delta TF as 0.40, and as we said that W2, why I am taking 2 for the solute 1 and then 1 is for the solvent, that will be 50, and delta TF directly given and KF value is also given. Only we need to calculate M2, directly apply the formula KF into W2 into 1000 divided by TF into W1, and KF value is 5.12 into 1 into 1000 divided by 0.40 into 50. If you calculate, that will be at around 256 gram per mole. Okay, as M2 molar mass is the unit for the molar mass is gram per mole. Finally, you have to put the unit, or else you are going to get the, or else you are going to lose your 1 mark. Clear? So, let us see other colligative properties in our next class. Thank you.